My name is Emma Rose Thayer, and today I will be talking about veterans and military families, particularly exploring mental illness within the family unit. Now, when I say military, maybe this is what comes to mind. The military soldier is revered and honored every day. They stand and receive an endless array of praise and applause, as they should. Now, maybe when I said military, this came to mind: the women of the military. However, behind every standing military soldier is a family. A family that experienced their deployment and served alongside them, although they could not be seen on the battlefield. The military family should be revered and honored every day for their sacrifices. This daily, lifelong servitude puts military families at a greater risk for developing mental health problems compared to their civilian counterparts. Mental health protocols need to extend past soldiers to their families. It is important to preserve a healthy mentality for military families so that their soldier may perform their duties to their utmost capabilities. Our nation not only depends on the soldier, but their families as well to fight for our freedom. Deployment after deployment, military children are uprooted and dislodged from ever feeling comfortable. Now you may be thinking, well, how does she know? Well, I come from a military family myself. My father, mother, and sister all served in the Army, and I experienced mental illness. A new school, a new home, and new friends every 6 months can be stressful enough, not even taking into fact the onslaught of puberty and hormones that come with adolescence. According to a study by Dr. Melinda Tartrian, 169 consenting military families were evaluated. What she discovered were that children exhibited higher rates of stress, anxiety, depression, attention deficit disorder, attention hyperactivity disorder. However, she also found that boys and older children were particularly at a greater risk for developing behavioral deficiencies on top of these psychological disorders. Now, the issue comes is that parents believe that this is simply a phase for their children due to the move. This belief causes a delay in seeking mental health professionals and help for their children. Now, mental health is just like any disease. Early treatment is needed in order to eradicate the disease. Parents need to watch out for their children and seek mental health as soon as they exhibit prolonged sadness or irritability, feelings of extreme highs and lows, excessive fears, worries, and anxieties, social withdrawal, dramatic changes in eating or sleeping habits, strong feelings of anger, delusions or hallucinations, growing inability to cope with daily problems and activities, suicidal thoughts, denial of obvious problems, numerous unexplained physical ailments, and excessive substance abuse. It is important for parents to not simply see these signs as a phase, but to seek mental treatment for their children. Now, what can we do? I believe that new mental health facilities available on all military bases with trained professionals specifically in the mental health of military families would be beneficial. Now, move by move, families are reallocated and don't have access to consistent mental health facilities. By providing them on all military bases, families will have access and be able to seek treatment no matter where they move. I also believe that military mental health facilities should have areas like this where children can play with one another, and community rooms where children can voice how they are feeling and realize that they are not alone. In addition, I believe that we should create preventative mental health programs that are available in all military-based schools. What that can entail is a trained mental health professional coming in once a month to speak to the children on ways to deal with stress, to cope with anxiety, or the signs that they may need to look for. In addition, I also believe that community programs can be a part of that preventative program. By giving children an outlet to meet one another, they could lower their chance of getting mental health issues. I wish that I had been given this opportunity with every move because it was so hard to meet new people. But by providing these programs, the children can meet one another and form a strong support network that can eradicate the onslaught of mental disorders. Now, you may be wondering, well, how are we going to afford this? Because building a new mental health facility on every single military base sounds expensive. And it is. But let's look at the 2019 tax spending budget. So, can you see the veterans' benefits? Perhaps let me illuminate it for you. Yeah, that's it. Only 4% of taxpayer dollars go to military families. 4%. That is alarming, to say the least, that we are only allocating 4% of our money to the people who put their lives on the line for our own lives. Now, let me ask, is 4% worth your life? I don't think so. I think we need to change how much is allocated to military families. Now, I'm not only talking about the mental health of military families who have a living soldier who are deployed, but I am also talking about the mental health of those who have lost a parent. You cannot even imagine the hardships that they experience, and the fact that we are only allocating 4% to their treatment of mental disorders is alarming. We need to change this problem. We as a nation must stand up for the people who give us a life to live. Thank you.